kids come to seventh grade from a variety of backgrounds. You know, we've got like 11 elementary schools that they're coming, that they could be coming from. There are private schools. There are other areas that have different focuses. So when we do things in the classroom that are going to require social interaction between peers, I make sure to teach how to do that. An example I can give as a writing teacher are peer conferences, right? Like it's great to get feedback from a peer and to offer feedback to a peer. It's a very important part of learning how to write. And so this is, again, having accumulated knowledge and experience my first year, I did it the way I had been taught, you know, hey, pick a partner, say something you like about what they wrote, something you don't like. And then what I noticed in my first year of teaching were students not knowing how to provide constructive feedback in a way that wasn't offensive. You know, we would have students who would just flat out say, wow, this sucks, or this is not good. Do you know what the assignment is? Have you looked at the rubric? Which is hateful and it's not constructive. And that's why now when we do approach that, I will tell students, okay, we do a lesson. How do you provide feedback in a way that's helpful? We model it. We might role play it a little bit with students, with each other. I also provide students sentence starters when they're going to be having really constructive conversations or ones that need to be academically productive. I do like to give them, hey, if you're not sure how to say this, here are some ways to start your sentences. Pass that out to every student. And that has helped, like I said, all students, not just those who are neurodivergent. There are just students who have never learned. How do I, in a productive academic way, tell a person in this classroom, you need to improve part of your essay or part of this piece of writing? And so then they have, oh, here are 9 different sentence starters that you can use to start your sentence out perfectly in a productive way that's not going to offend somebody and lead into a good conversation. And we do that with other things too, like we are getting ready to read New Kid by Jerry Craft. And Jerry Craft is actually coming to visit my building next week. We're very excited about that. And so this is a book that touches on a lot of stereotypes and microaggressions. And so I wouldn't just teach that. I will teach it. I mean, but I'm going to teach what are stereotypes, what are microaggressions, and help students have those conversations about a tough topic. You know, seventh grade, students are often very uncomfortable talking about race or gender. I get a lot of students who, if I mention a character is black in a book, they'll say, well, oh, that's racist. You said the character is black. No, that's not. So, okay, let's talk about how do you have a conversation about race in a way that's productive. We just did stereotypes in advertising. That's something I teach as well. And stereotypes are in the standards for seventh grade English. And so we were going through different ads that played on gender and race stereotypes. And we talked about it. And I said, hey, when we introduced that lesson, I said, I know that sometimes people can feel uncomfortable talking about race, talking about gender. And I said, we're just here to analyze advertisements. We are going to look for certain stereotypes. And so then that was, let's have an intentional conversation about how do we have these conversations? What do we not say when we're talking about these things? What are some hard lines and boundaries? And that's good for all kids.